Southern residents are amazing animals. They live in stable family groups. They use sound to communicate with each other and to find their food. Southern residents are fish eaters. They like Chinook salmon in particular. And they're just really unique parts of our culture here in the Pacific Northwest. Southern resident killer whales are endangered, and their population level is the lowest we've seen in several decades. There's three main threats. We're not sure the whales are getting enough of their Chinook salmon prey to eat. The whales also use sound to find their food, and so vessels and sound in the environment can interfere with their ability to find prey. The whales have high levels of contaminants. Because they're such a small population, they're at risk for something like an oil spill or a disease outbreak that could affect the entire population. There's an active research program so we can learn more about how these threats are affecting the whales and inform conservation and management actions to address those threats. We're using passive acoustic monitors in the environment to understand how the whales are using that habitat. We can also use digital acoustic tags, and those tags help us understand the whale's behavior, how they're diving, how they're responding to sound and vessels in their environment, and how that might impact their foraging activity. We're using drones to take aerial photos of the whales. We can look at their body condition and see if they're getting enough to eat. We can also tell if females are pregnant. We can collect scales and tissue from the prey that they're eating. And we can also get breath samples and understand pathogens that might be causing disease for the whales. And then there's killer whale poop. By collecting samples following behind the whales, we're able to learn about what they're eating. We can get genetics of the salmon as well as the individual whales. We can also learn about hormones and contaminants. Killer whale poop has a wealth of information. Southern residents have been identified as a species in the spotlight because of their population decline as well as their high risk for extinction. Some of the new initiatives that have come out of this program are partnerships at the Canadian level with the state of Washington and at the local level. Priority actions include increasing critical prey for the whales, understanding what's causing problems with their health and their reproduction. I'm hopeful that there is a chance for recovery of southern resident killer whales. They're such an essential element of our ecosystem. And if we can all work together to support recovery, they can once again thrive as part of the food web and the ecosystem that we all share into the future.